Hello, my name is Cindy McGarry, and I will be discussing my internship programs project for the APIC 2020-2021 Call to Action on Equity, Inclusion, Diversity, Justice, and Social Responsivity. I'm located at UT Health San Antonio, and our project title was Addressing Patient Discriminatory Behaviors in Training. Our clinical internship program's DEI committee wanted to develop a policy and training to provide both supervisors and trainees guidance on how to address patients who exhibit racist and discriminatory behaviors. We know that acts of discrimination can be harmful to healthcare workers and leads to distress and burnout. And at least in the immediate wake of these incidents, learning has been found to at least temporarily stop. Currently, little guidance exists to help trainees and supervisors address these types of behaviors, particularly in the field of psychology, where we are expected to be non-judgmental and supportive in our interactions with patients. So as part of this project, we conducted a literature review and surveyed our current and past interns, as well as faculty, to determine the need for such a policy. It was determined by our survey that 70% of our faculty and trainees thought this policy would be either extremely useful or very useful. We modified our policy from the standardized approach to racist patient interactions developed by Drs. Duggan, White, Davis, and Tattleman, located at the Montefiore Medical Center Development of Family and Social Medicine. I'll discuss the policy in more detail in the next slide. We obtained feedback from both faculty and interns to help revise the policy. We then developed a workshop to not only train the new policy, but to provide information and skills to address patient discriminatory behaviors. This workshop was conducted via Zoom due to the pandemic and included video vignettes, polls, chats, and breakout rooms in the presentation to optimize discussion. We utilize Goldenberg's, Wilkins, and Cyrus's ERACE model. ERACE stands for expecting that discrimination will occur, because expecting it to occur allows for planning on how to address these occurrences, recognizing when it occurs, addressing problem behaviors, supporting trainees, and establishing a positive culture. This model is primarily for medical trainees, so we added additional resources in the address section of the presentation to be more applicable to psychology. This workshop was given to 28 faculty, interns, and fellows, and feedback was that faculty and interns felt more knowledgeable on how to address patient racist and discriminatory behaviors. Additionally, faculty reported feeling better prepared to discuss and support trainees when these situations occur. We strongly encourage that each training site or organization have a standardized process to managing racist and discriminatory patient interactions, individualized to their own site and patient population. So here's an overview of our policy. Interns are encouraged to discuss racist or discriminatory interactions with patients with their supervisors. The supervisors will facilitate dialogue with the trainee to plan an appropriate strategy to address the behavior. A supervisor should not reinforce a patient's harmful behaviors by immediately changing the provider. But if the trainee chooses not to see that patient, that should be allowed. If the trainee continues with the patient, the supervisor should follow the case closely. Wraparound support is provided to the trainee, as well as long-term support if necessary. The supervisors report these occurrences to the program directors, and the program directors also follow up with the trainee. These occurrences are documented, and the internship training committee will review these occurrences at least annually during our faculty retreat day to address the overall effects of the policy and to make revisions if necessary. This link goes to our webpage where you can access the policy. This is my contact information. Please feel free to reach out with any questions. Thank you.